Hello everyone. Today we will discuss the amphibia, class amphibia, characteristics of that and the representative examples from amphibia and the classification of amphibia. These amphibians are cold-blooded animals. That means their body temperature fluctuates with the environmental temperature. In amphibia, the skin is smooth or rough and rich in glands, so that secretion of this gland keep the skin moist and thus helps in the respiration. The scales are generally absent, but if present, they are embedded in the skin or hidden in the skin. The limbs are tetrapodous. Tetra means four. Poda means digits. Means on the forelimbs and the hind limbs, that is tetrapodous, means the two forelimbs and the two hind limbs are there. Then the pentadactyle. Penta means five. Dactyle means digits. Means as human beings having the five fingers, like that, these animals having the five digits. Some animals in the amphibia, these are the limbless, without limb, that is forelimb and hind limb. The heart in these amphibia is three-chambered, these having two auricles and one ventricle. The gills are present at least during some early larval stages of development. And so they have to, the early stages of their life cycle, they are passed in the aquatic habitat. And therefore, these animals compulsorily go to the water bodies for the reproduction. The cranial nerves are pain pairs. The eggs with gelatinous covering and usually laid in the water, because these animals have to compulsorily go to the aquatic habitat as the development is indirect and their larvae or the early stages, they complete the metamorphosis in the water. The larvae pass through an aquatic stage before metamorphosing into the adult. These are the characteristics. Features of the amphibia. Then the first example from the amphibia, that is the ichthyophis. The classification of ichthyophis, that is the phylum Chordata, group Vertebrata, subphylum Gnathostomata, class amphibia, order Apoda, and genus is the ichthyophis. Before discussing that, we will discuss the classification of amphibia. The amphibia class, it is divided into three orders. One is called as Apoda, another one is the Anura, and the third one is the Urodela. These are the three orders, and you have to study the one representative example from each order. That is, from Apoda, example is the Ichthyophis. From Anura, it is a two-toed, that is a buffo, and from Urodela, it is a salamander. First of all, we'll discuss the Ichthyophis. Ichthyophis belongs to the order Apoda. This is the figure of the Ichthyophis. This is the tail, the body, trunk, and the head. Means body is divided into head, trunk, and the tail region. This is a limbless, and these eyes are hidden. And that therefore it is also called as a Sicilian, or it is also called as a blind worm. And the Ichthyophis is a burrowing animal, elongated and eel-like, and measure up to 30 cm in length. As we have earlier discussed, the body is divided into head, trunk, and the tail. The skin having the transverse grooves in which minute scales are hidden or the embedded. Limbs and limb girdles are entirely absent. there is no limb. The forelimbs are also absent, hind limbs are also absent, as well as the girdles are also not there. Tail is short and vestigial. The eyes are minute and these are devoid of eyelids. Means eyelids are absent and buried deep in the head, and these eyes are the non-functional, and therefore it is called as a blind worm. The sexes are separate and fertilization is internal and parental care is very well developed. Means this ischiophys, it cares for their eggs up to the total development. This is the first example from the amphibia. Then the second example from amphibia, which belongs to the another order, that is Anura. Anura includes all the, that is the frogs and the toads in this order. Bappo is a what? It is commonly called as a true toad. Skin is a rough, dry and having the warts. This warty skin on the dorsal surface of the body and has more poisonous gland than the mucus gland. It having the parotid gland, which is a poisonous gland, and head bears a wide mouth, large protruding eyes with eyelids and very small nostrils. Then the tympanum or middle bone, this is a tympanum, this is a middle ear bone, it is very well developed, that is a middle ear. The external ear pinna is not there, internal ear and middle ear is there, that is the tympanum is very well developed. Then paired parotid glands are present behind the tympanum, and this gland, it secretes a irritating poisonous fluid. The forelimb bears a finger and a thumb pad. This is a forelimb and it bears a fingers and a thumb pad. Hind limbs having the how many toes? That is a three toes with a greatly reduced web. Means the web is reduced. The teeth are not there or entirely absent in the mouth. Eggs are laid in a water in a gelatinous string. And this parotid gland, it secretes a toxin. It causes a nausea, disturbance in respiration and muscles, and also effect on hard functioning of the its prey organism or the small organism. So see, these are the characteristic features of the Bappo or the true toad. And the third example from the this amphibia is the example from the order Urodela. Uro means tail. That is the those amphibians having the long tail, that is the included under the Urodela. All the types of the salamanders are included under the order Urodela. It is commonly known as European fire salamander. The body is lizard-like in appearance, and if you measuring 12 to 15 cm in length, males are shorter than the females. The color is shining black with yellow spots on the back and the limbs. Body is divisible into, this is a head region, then middle one is a trunk region, and the last is a tail region. The head bears wide mouth, nostrils and a pair of eyes with eyelids. A pair of parotid gland behind the head is also present. The limbs are very well developed and strong. Tail is cylindrical. These are viviparous, means they directly give birth to their larvae or new young one. The tail, the limbs are, these are viviparous, and about 15 embryos or the larvae develop into the oviduct. Young one hatch having a external gills which are shed before hatching. Means the what they give, they releases the what, they go to the water body and directly releases the young ones having the external gills, and therefore they having ability to respire within the water, and after that they will metamorphose and they will become an adult. So these are characteristic features of the cell amanda.